Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'm going to explain you Sealy window syndrome and its solution in TCP. So first of all, you need to understand what is the meaning of Sealy window syndrome. See, Sealy window syndrome that comes under the category when we have ineffective utilization of bandwidth and resources, which we have it on computer network. So whenever you are using TCP, at that time, sometimes because of some issues, you may be having ineffective utilization of resources. Like as if window size is full at receiver side, at that time also we are using bandwidth with lower capacity, as if you have slower sender, as if you have slower receiver. In that case also, we are having ineffective utilization of bandwidth and resources. So I'll explain you all these three cases along with solutions with practical example. So let us discuss first scenario in which we are having window size that is full at receiver side. Let me show you that first. You see what is happening is here sender is sending data to receiver, where if you observe at receiver side, window size is full. And as if window size is full at receiver side, what will happen? When segment comes to receiver, at that time it will give acknowledgement, and in acknowledgement it will advertise window size, in which it will say window size is zero. What it means? Window at receiver is full. And as if window at receiver is full, sender will run persistent timer over here, and after persistent timer it will be sending segment in which it will be saying probe frame. It will be saying probe frame, and that probe frame, when it reaches to receiver, at that time again as if window is full, at that time again it will be saying my window is full by advertising window size is equals to zero, and again persistent timer will run. So here what is happening, you see here on the channel in between source and destination, bandwidth is available, but because of window size over here at receiver is full, sender cannot send data to receiver, right? And here this issue comes as and when application layer is bit slow at receiver side. You see what is happening here, we are having application layer and two application layer. Here transport layer will give data, right? But as if application layer is not consuming data, then this transport layer cannot supply data to application layer. The reason is application is not consuming data from window. That's why window size that is staying full. And because of window size is full, this receiver will have to send acknowledgement along with window size is equals to zero. And sender is waiting for persistent timer. So here what is happening, you see, for this much time period, we are ineffectively utilizing the bandwidth of the system. Now what is the solution for this? See, solution is just reset the connection. Why we need to reset the connection? The reason is every time when sender is probing destination regarding sending data, at the time receiver is saying my window is full. That's why we need to reset the connection. We need to redefine the size of window, and as if we define size of window with bit higher capacity, in that case the sender can supply data to receiver. So for this type of issue, solution is reset the connection. Now let us discuss about second issue, that is slower sender. So here if you observe, see, we are having sender and receiver. Here sender is sending segment, and in that you see 1 byte data that we are forwarding. Receiver is giving acknowledgement, sender is sending 1 byte, 1 byte, 1 byte, receiver is giving acknowledgement to all the segments. But as if sender is sending very few things, like 1 byte data, what is the meaning of it? You just think about the practical scenario in which transport layer header, that size that will be minimum by 20 byte. After transport layer, there will be network layer, right? So in network layer, again, we are adding header. Now that header size, that is even greater than the size of data which is available over here. So practically what we are doing is we are wasting bandwidth of the channel. If you send 1 byte, 2 byte, 1 byte, 2 byte data with every packet, what will happen? You are utilizing the system. But in that, data is there in terms of few percentage only, and large size of data that we transmit in terms of headers only. Because of that, you can say this is ineffective transmission over here. So what is the solution for this type of issue in which sender is slower? So simple solution that was given by Nagel's algorithm, in which it was saying that we need to wait for round trip time before we send the data. So just wait for round trip time, after that send the data. So if you wait for some time, what will happen? If you wait for some time before you send the data, you will be gathering some data. Like you see, application layer is supplying data to transport layer over here, right? So if you wait for some time, then application layer will gather bit more data, and that larger size of data, now that we will be supplying it to transport layer, and then transport layer will supply that data to network layer, and then network layer will supply that data to data link layer, and then we will be forwarding that on physical layer. So here, if you wait for round trip time before you forward the data, then application layer will be gathering bit more data, and in that case we can avoid unnecessary headers on the channel. The reason is, on channel, if you transmit information in which only headers are there, then what is the use of those things, right? So here, solution is provided by Nagel's algorithm, in which we will be waiting for round trip time to send the data, right? Now you see, third issue that I would like to discuss, that is regarding slower receiver. So you see, in slower receiver, what will happen? See here, sender is sending data to receiver, but receiver is slower. Why I'm saying that is slower? The reason is, here application layer will be taking data from transport layer. Now, as if application layer that is slow, then it will consume very few bytes from transport layer. At transport layer, here we are having window. Now, this window will supply data to application layer. But if application layer is slow, then this window cannot get empty earlier. So what will happen? You see, here sender is sending data. It is sending data 1 byte only. Why? The reason is, receiver cannot receive data which is more than 1 byte, as only 1 byte window that is free. And as 1 byte window that is free, it is giving acknowledgement. Along with that, it is advertising window size that is 1 byte. It is saying, like, my 1 byte is free right now, so you can send me 1 byte data as per window size is equals to 1 byte. Then sender will be sending 1 byte. Again, it is saying, I'm having 2 byte size of window. So sender is sending 2 byte. Again, it is saying, oh, I am having 1 byte size of window. So here, because of receiver is slow, this window is not full. Remember previously what I have said, here in case of persistent timer, we have been having full window. But here, as receiver is slow, this window is not full. Here window is having little free size. And because of little free size that is there with this receiver, receiver is advertising window size by 2 bytes, 1 byte, 3 bytes. And based on that, sender is allowed to send 1 byte, 2 byte. The reason is, sender cannot send more than the data which is free over here, right? So here, because of this receiver is slow, there is issue. This is also referred as silly window syndrome. Now, what is the solution for this? You see, solution is Clark's solution, in which, see what Clark is saying. Clark is saying that don't send acknowledgement till maximum segment size or half of the buffer size is free. So solution is what? You see, solution is, here this receiver will have to give acknowledgement, but do not send acknowledgement immediately. Like, I'm having 1 byte free, send 1 byte. See, do not do that. What Clark is saying is, receiver should wait before it sends acknowledgement. And receiver will have to wait for how much time? Receiver will have to wait till this window is getting empty, or half of this window is getting empty. before that receiver should not give acknowledgement. So that is what the solution that has been provided by Clark. So these are the three major issues in which what will happen here, our bandwidth utilization, or you can say bandwidth equipment, bandwidth allocation, that will be very false, that you can say, in terms of data transmission. Why? The reason is, here if you observe, in some instant you will be forwarding 1 byte, 2 byte data, but along with that header size will be large. So in terms of percentage, if you calculate how much data that we transmit, then that will be hardly few percentage, right? And see, in that situation you can say unnecessary traffic that we are forwarding on the computer network. But to avoid all those issues, few solutions are also there, right? And those solutions even I have discussed over here. Still, if anything that you would like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.